Hello and welcome. My name is Stefan Cech. I'm a DOP, certified glide cam trainer and operator, and filmmaker from Germany.
In collaboration with GlideCam US, I produce this series called GlideCam Training.
To get the most out of your handheld stabilizer from GlideCam, I will show you how to stand properly, how to move the system up, down, forwards and backwards, how to go over obstacles or in circle. Before we start, make sure that your system is perfectly static and dynamic balanced and had a drop time between 1.5 and 2 seconds.
One of the most common questions for people they start to walk around or to move around the camera is the focus. So today let's focus on the focus. How to deal with this, how to keep the focus on our motive, if it's in the center or on the side, if it's moving or we move around. And many people think that the aperture is the most important part of the focus pulling or to deal with a shallow depth of field, but it's not, it's the sensor size. So if you deal with a full frame sensor, you get a really easy shallow depth of field. It's not easy to control when you move your camera. If you have a S35, it becomes a little bit easier because the shallow depth of field is not so big. And with a smaller sensor like on a GH4, it's a completely different story. The next part is the focal length. So if you choose a 35 or a 40 millimeter, makes a huge difference depending on the sensor size you use. Like I show in a further workshop, the full frame versus the S35 and Micro Four Thirds sensor in regard to the crop factor makes a huge difference with the same lens. The next part, of course, is the aperture. But keep in mind that the aperture is in a ratio to the sensor size. So on a full frame sensor, a 5.6 aperture is nearly the same like an 2.8 from the shallow depth of field on a S35 camera. And the distance to your subject. Let's say we have a wide angle shot, nearly everything is in focus. But when you go closer to your flower, to your whatever, you get a much more shallow depth of field. Okay, let's rephrase. We have the sensor size of choice, we have the focal length we want to use, and we have the aperture, and of course the distance to our object. So how we can deal with this on our moving glide cam? We have three options. The first option is the fixed focus. So we set the focus on our lens on a fixed point, and so we have to keep the distance to the subject. So if the subject is moving, we have to keep up and keep the same distance between the camera and the motive. It's pretty easy. On a manual lens, I have the ability to choose the focus a little bit more precise than on an autofocus lens. And as you see here, it works pretty well. So this is a 24 millimeter set on, I think it was a 4 or a 5.6, and I keep the distance to my motive. Here it is a wide angle shot. It's not a big deal to keep everything in focus. Here we have the same distance to my subject. And in the next shot, I use the 70 millimeter. Not a big deal if you keep the distance. This is a wide angle shot, so you don't see a shift of the focus when you go closer. But you can use the same techniques to come into focus, like on this shot. The second option is the professional one. It's a wireless focus control. For this you need the equipment, the motor, the controller, and of course a capable person. It calls the first AC, it's the focus puller. This is the professional version. With the newer cameras, we get a third option. It is the autofocus. Here I use the Canon C100 Mark II with the dual pixel autofocus. And as you see, it works pretty well. But you have only a small window of 20% of the whole picture. It works with the autofocus. And of course you have to use an autofocus lens. I use the 18-35 1.8 from Sigma, a perfect choice for this camera and for this application. I keep my motif in the frame and everything works pretty well. In this shot it works perfectly. The beautiful girl walks right in the middle of my frame, and so I can keep the focus on her while I'm going around, follow her and change the distance to my subject. Pretty cool. Here on the shooting stage, I follow the shooter, and as you see, the focus will shift with him and keep on him when I keep him in the center of the frame. It works pretty well. But of course, the autofocus had the limitation. As you see here, I keep on Thomas and then I shift to the side, boom, the autofocus, go to the background, and this is not what I want. So you see, this is not an easy part, because while I'm going around with the glide cam, I can't choose a different part where I want to have my focus, or in this shot. And boom, the autofocus went on the background. Yes, and now we have the famous cathedral in Cologne right in focus. But it was not a big deal, because this was not a one-shot wonder. Different shots and we can edit together, so it was not a big deal at this point. But you see, it can help you, but it can makes you a lot of trouble if you use it on the wrong side. Probably on this scene, the fixed focus would not be a bad idea. So let's rephrase. We have the sensor size, we have the aperture, and we have the right choice of the lens. Wide angle lens makes it easier, but it's sometimes a little bit boring, and the distance to your subject is important. You have a lot to train, go out and shoot with this. And best regards, your Stefan Cech.